What a cozy room for a discussion, isn't it? I don't know if I have pleasant, those of us who are here in the bank, we don't, I'm not sure if we have pleasant memories here. There's been a number of interesting talks given and a lot of boring talks and a lot of speeches by bank hierarchy to, and, you know, give us information or yell at us. So this room has, it's not one of my favorite rooms. But as people come, I wanted to welcome you to this late morning session. I'm Ron Hoffer with the Europe and Central Asia region of the World Bank. I guess I'm the appropriate person to at least think about these issues since I was the safeguards lead for Europe and Central Asia for 4 years and have been now the region's climate change coordinator for the last 3 years. So I'm pleased to be here. And this session, we're going to go beyond North America. Sounds like going beyond North America is probably wise anyway if we want to learn about EIA and climate change. But that's the title of this session. In that spirit, the format we're going to use is we're going to have a talk by Shardul Agrawala, who is a senior economist with OECD's Environment Directive, and Directorate, and he's going to give you an overview of a publication that's been released about 2 months ago, of which there were some copies available and more can be sent, which I think is a really interesting view of what's going on around the world, and also some recommendations on how EIA can be incorporated in the, how climate change can be incorporated in the EIA process at different stages. And his will be the longest presentation, and I think will give us a summary of what's going on. And then we're going to have four discussants who I'll keep to, you know, 7 minutes or so each to present their perspective on one or more aspects of what Shardul presented from the perspective of the United Kingdom, the Netherlands, and then Australia. And then finally, Ken Markowitz from the International Network for Environmental Compliance and Enforcement will reflect on this from his network's perspective more globally. So again, we're going to have Shardul first and then go to, as the program says, Glenn Watts, Rob Verheem, and Simon Smalley. And so with that, let me turn the podium over to you. If some of us are looking like we can't see, it's because we have a blinding spotlight in our face, so, which we may walk away from it.